Hey guys, it's Michelle and welcome back to my channel. So today's video, I'm going to show you this makeup look. Something about brow, mauve, matte and warm tone. I am so in love with this look and this is so suitable for fall season as well. Although my country is a tropical country, but that doesn't matter. Anyway, before we moving on with makeup tutorial, I just want to let you know I created this eye makeup look using this palette from the Candy Skin. And if you are following my channel for quite some time, then I think you are quite familiar with this brand because I'm featuring many of their products which I'm so in love. And recently they just came out with 6 eyeshadow quads and the limited edition eyeshadow palettes. To be honest, they don't have the name for this palette, so I'm not sure the name of it and I'm not sure if this palette is official on sale or not, but these 6 eyeshadow quads are absolutely stunning. And I will be giving out these 6 eyeshadow quads on my Instagram. So if you are keen to try it out, just head over to my Instagram, The Chancy. I will put the link in the description box below. Check it out, click it, and yeah, without further ado, let's jump right into the tutorial. Hey guys, so like always, I love to start out with skincare first. Today's video, I will be using this Thermal Spring Water by Ovane. Spread it and pat in the moisture deep into my skin and done. I'm not done with my skincare. Next, I'm going to use this Pip Star Eye Cream from Clinique. This eye cream is so good. It shoots away my puffy eye and it's so moisturizing. Also, it will be the base for my concealer later. Of course, I'm not going to neglect my lips. I'm using the Soft Lip Cube. So this is a Soft Lips Cube lip balm. It is strawberry flavor, very yummy. Oops, the wrong one. Girls, if you have dry lips, please do not skip this step. This works so well. Okay, moving on to the base. For the primer today, I am using this Famous Amos Hourglass Mineral Veil Primer. This primer is so good as well, but I know the price is not good at all. Then for today's foundation, I am using one of my favorite foundation. This is from Shiseido, Synchro Skin Lasting Liquid Foundation, and my shade is in N2 Neutral 2. And for today's brush, I am using this beautiful rose gold oval brush from My Makeup Brush Set to apply and buff the foundation blends into the skin. I'm not only to conceal but also to highlight my face as well. I'm taking this Double Way Stay In Flawless Way Concealer from Estee Lauder. Of course, I'm applying under my eye area to cover my dark circle, also to the part that I want to highlight as well. Then taking my lovely Damp Beauty Blender and just blend it out. Before I'm going to set my face with powder, I want to fill my brow first. I'm going to use an eyebrow powder just to roughly fill in the gap between my brows. And then I will switch to the Skinny Brow Pencil to define it better. Okay, many of you guys are asking for the eyebrow tutorial. To be honest, I don't have a special tricks or tips to my eyebrow. I just draw following my natural eyebrow shape. But if you guys really want one, of course, I will do a specific one for you guys, so yeah, maybe soon. For this look, I want a softer eyebrow look, so I'm going to use a lighter shade of eyebrow gel and just make it softer because my brows are pretty dark and I don't want them to stand out too much. Then I'm taking some concealer again to create a clean outline. Let's set the face by baking. I'm using a Damp Beauty Blender, dip some powder and dab it to push the powder onto the skin. Now I love the Shiseido Translucent Powder even more than La Roche Posay one because this is white color powder which can brighten up my face, while the La Roche Posay one is more like my skin tone color. After that, I'm taking a white fresh powder by Maybelline to set the rest of my face. Moving on to the eyes, first I'm going to prime my eyes. This is eye primer by the Candy Skin in shade Champagne. The reason why I'm using a champagne color as a base is because the rest of it will be in matte color, so it will give some dimension base to it. That's what I thought. Now what I said in the beginning of the video, for this makeup look, I'm using the Candy Skin Limited Edition Eyeshadow Palette. It has a such beautiful warm mauve tones with a combination of matte and shimmer eyeshadow inside. First, I'm going to take this milk chocolate color and apply this to my mobile eyelid area. I am mostly patting the eyeshadow onto my lid and it is definitely fine if looking pretty harsh, because after this, I will blend it out. Also, I will apply this to my lower lash line as well. Anyway, the brush that I'm using here is a Crease Blending Blush by Brilliant Beauty. It is so soft and thank you for sending me this eyebrow set. I love it so much. So if you guys are interested to buy, I will put the shop link in the description box below. Guys, I'm not getting paid for this. I really like your brushes and let's support local brand. Okay, next I'm going to combine this reddish brown color and a dark brown together and apply it to my lid area. This eye look is super easy to create, no skill required, just perfect for everyone, especially beginner. Taking the reddish brown again, and this time I'm going to apply to my lower lash line layer on top. Then choosing the dark brown again and apply it to the outer corner of my lower lash line. And then just finalize it with blending to make it softer, because the key of this makeup look is no harsh line. Yes, that's it. It's time for the eyeliner. For the eyeliner, I'm divided into two parts. So the first part is using a black eyeliner and then going to tightline my waterline. Then the second part, I'm using a coffee color of eyeliner, and this is also from the Candy Skin. This time I'm going to draw a soft cat eye look. Okay, it's almost done. To complete, curl the lashes and apply some mascara to the top and bottom lashes. If you want looking glamour, go ahead with fall lashes, but try not using a drama lashes. A soft natural or brown color fall lashes will be perfect. I'm just lazy, so I skip it. Giving some definition back to my face, I am using my favorite Sweetheart Bronzer in Milk Tea by Too Faced, and I will only apply it to the outer corner of my face. For the nose contour, I'm going to use the other one because that bronzer is a Radiance Bronzer. So I will be using this matte contour, and this is Define and Conquer Contour Kit by 17. Apply it to the side of my nose, below my lips, and in between of my cupid bows. For the blush today, I'm choosing a nude peachy color blush and apply it to my cheeks. I want my cheek to be really soft and natural. For the highlight, I am using a soft champagne color and just apply it to the area that I want an extra pop. This highlight is really soft and not too intense, so it's perfect for this makeup look. Moving on to the lips, I'm going to mixing two lips products together to create the right color that I want. First, I'm going to swatch nude peach color on my hand and then mix it with some brown color into it. I want the color to have some brown tone inside, just like giving a spice. You got what I mean, right? And then I just applied it to my lips. I want a full lips but a defined one, so I'm taking a sponge and dip some concealer to soften the edges out, so this lid will be softer. Anyway, try overdraw a little bit of your lips so you will get a soft fuller lips. And yeah, this makeup is done. Okay, thank you so much for being here with me. I hope you like this makeup tutorial, and if you like this, please do give me a thumbs up to my family by subscribe my channel, and also feel free to leave a comment, because you know I always love to hear from you guys. So yeah, that's it for today's video, and I will see you soon on my next video. Love you. Bye.